I don't think you need a ceremony and a certificate to, you know, reiterate your love for someone. If you love them, you love them. You don't need a ceremony in a church to show,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But I think before you needed marriage as a sort of like commitment, but now it's just, it's gone, really. I don't think you need marriage. But
okay.
There you go. Depends.
Yeah, depends.
Deep words from
I don't really think it exists. But I think that you can, but I think you can find someone that you really, really like,
yeah.
That you want to spend. I think you don't go into a relationship thinking, I love you and passion. You go into it thinking, you're a really good friend that I like spending time in and stuff. So it's more like friendship being.
Agnes,
what about you, Mrs. I Love You?
Well, I come from like a really good family. Like all my relatives and parents, they are all like happily married.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. I mean, I think love exists. But it's not like maybe forever. Like if you like marry your best friend, then it's okay because one love is gonna finish. You still like can
yeah.
talk and have fun. But yeah, that's it.
You love someone, but then you also like I don't know. I think like love is like being with someone that you like your friend. You know? Like what Anna said.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Not like this whole passion business.
I mean, yeah, you can have passion as well, but like friends, you know, something makes you laugh.
Yeah.
I think passion exists at the beginning, which is
yeah.
like the beginning of a relationship. And then when the passion goes, you really know if you love someone, because you might stay with them or choose not to. I think marriage is a good idea. And I think if people go through with it and stick with it, then I have respect for them. But if the love dies and they don't want to be together, then there's no point in forcing yourself together just because you're like you think you should just because you got married. You know? So I think divorce is a good idea.
Yeah. Okay, so my mother is Christian, my father is an atheist, so I have a bit of both views on how marriage is.
Yeah.
So my mother always tells me that marriage is really, really important, that it should be treasured.
Yeah.
And like, you, even if some passion goes away, you have to be responsible when you marry the person.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, my father, he's a little more open-minded. But they love each other, though, despite their opposites. So they've been together for 30 years or so.
Wow.
Yay. So personally, I believe that there's like
yeah.
mainly the beginning, like you said, there's more passionate stuff. But I think it can continue throughout the relationship if you try to like commit to spending time with them and trying to get to know them more,
mm-hmm.
learn to love their good sides and bad sides.
Yeah, that's about being able to share yourself with that other person. Not feel judged or have to try and justify what you're doing. That person will accept you for who you are and vice versa. In terms of marriage, I don't think it's necessary at all. While it's nice to have a day to celebrate your love together, I think it's not needed. You know, why stick to one day when you can have the rest of your lives?
Oh my
God.
Someone's been on Tumblr this morning.
You need to put a post action.
I guess find the person who you can just chill with and no need to be all really serious with them in a way that, oh my god, they think about me. Just have a person you're comfortable with that understands you and you understand them. I don't know. But marriage, like most people said, not really necessary if you don't really want to go into marriage, but if you want to tie that knot.
Okay.
Spend the rest of life together.
I have a lot of thoughts on love, but they're all separated into different types of love. Like, there's a way I love my friends, and then there's the way if I had a boyfriend, I would love that person, and then there's the way I love pizza, you know? Love but I think that love, regardless of where you put it, it's with another person. It's all about learning to love them in a way that they feel loved, because personally, I think there's different types of like way you feel love. Like I feel especially love when people spend time with me, but if you give me a hug, it makes me feel extremely awkward, and I don't feel loved that way. I'm just like, let go away. So I think when you get married to someone, it's about learning how to express love in a way that they accept it and they hold, makes them feel treasured and like they belong. And so I'm also a deep believer in Jesus Christ, so I think any good relationship, if you're going into marriage, it needs to be on a foundation of, like, I love God, and I'm going to love him first, and then I'm going to love my significant other as imperfectly as I can, as perfectly as I can as an imperfect person.
Yeah.
And I think that like modern Western people have gotten away from understanding that like no one's going to be perfect in marriage, because they go in with all that passion of like, I can't see anything wrong with that person. No, you need to go in with like, yeah, this person can be extremely selfish and gets angry really easily, but I'm going to love them anyways because I'm imperfect, because I'm lazy and I talk too much and I know all the bad things about myself, and they know that too. And even if I find more, I'm still going to love them through that. So, I mean, what it boils down to, that long ramble rant, comes down to loving people for who they are in a way that makes them feel loved, instead of forcing your idea of this is how I'm going to love you because it makes me feel loved, when it could be completely wrong for that person. Like, my friends are like, I'm going to give you a hug, and I'm like, please don't. And so we now have an understanding of Sheena doesn't exactly feel loved when you give her a hug. She feels loved when you go and you sit down and have dinner with her.
Yeah.
20
as hell.
Yeah, they have to make you laugh.
Yeah,
three.
Yeah,
just someone you like click with, someone you get along with, really.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah.
And funny, of course.
Yeah,
funny.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah.
Talk
yeah.
to.
Like,
yeah.
And you don't feel awkward.
Yeah.
Someone that like you don't have to speak all the time. You can just enjoy their company as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No
awkward
silence. Someone you feel
yeah,
comfortable
yeah.
even if like just like silent.
Huh? See that?
And like,
quick.
Yeah. Adventurous.
Mm.
Yes.
Adventurous.
I say adventurous.
Adventurous.
Yeah, someone that like pushes you like to always do your best.
Mm-hmm.
Ah.
Motivate.
Yeah, a better person.
Like this.